about the Diablos. You are new in Liberty, but already you are gaining a reputation on the streets. There is a street race starting by the old school hall near the Callahan Bridge. Get yourself some wheels, and first through all the checkpoints wins the prize.
Yes, you are. I'm sure it's very exciting for you, but what do you want to talk about?
Oh, man, I mean, what else is there? I could go on all day, but you know how it is, don't you, Laszlo?
Not really. What's your name? What did you call about?
I'm Maria, you know, Maria, like Mamma Mia, only different, you know, but, you know, men, M-E-N. Oh, it's a dirty word, only there's only three letters. You know what I mean? I mean, your broadcasters are all the same, aren't you? I mean, I heard about you. You're always out on boys' nights.
Whoa, what are you talking about? I'm married.
One of those convenience jobs to protect you, I bet. I know what you're all like. You know more about men than I know about leopard skin furniture. So listen to club stuff and give me some advice. I mean, come on, I got real problems. You see, okay, I had this boyfriend, and at first, he was real kind to me. He was a real gentleman. A little bit older and everything, but yeah, he treated me really good. And then it all went wrong, and so, you know, I found someone else, and real nice, but you know, he don't talk too much, so I really can't tell if he likes me. Well, I guess what I want to know is, you know, how do you tell if a guy is serious? I mean, you know, he treats me good, but he don't seem real interested in me. He's always working and hanging out with the guys. Say, you don't think he's like you, do you?
What do you mean, like me? What are you insinuating? That he's on the radio? Well, probably not. You're listening to Chatterbox, where your opinion matters, or at least we say that. Let's go over here to line four. Hello, caller, what's your name?
Jeff from Rockford.
Hello, Jeff, what's up?
I wanted to tell you and your listeners about a once-in-a-lifetime chance to make a difference. There's a rally tomorrow evening at the park, starting at 7. Although we'll be painting banners and theme songs all night and all day to prepare for it. Then, when tens of thousands gather at the park, we're going to march on the town hall. Laszlo, the people have spoken. They have said no, not invite them. So, folks, if you're listening and want to make a difference, get yourself down to the park and prepare to bring democracy back to the people.
So, what's this rally about, Joe?
It's about people standing up and being counted. It's about the future. It's about telling those small arms and no thanks, not in my town. Not while I have a breath in my body and hope in my soul. I will not, I cannot let this pass.
Let what pass?
It's about grabbing the town by the balls and saying, listen, put up or shut up. No more Mr. Nice Guy. No more easy solutions to difficult problems. It's about what it means to be an American. It's about giving something back.
Giving what back, Jeff?
Hope, dreams, belief.
Belief in what? I mean, look, Jeff, I admire your passion. Really, I do. But what will people be marching for? What's your rally about?
It's about justice, Mr. Lowe. A chance to shine and make a difference. About thousands of people walking side by side as brother marching. Only one thing on their mind. A chance to make a difference. Bring your friends. Nothing shows a man how much you mean to him more than a chance to walk together for justice. Bring your kids. They can paint signs, and we'll even have a face painter and a vegan barbecue. Bring your parents. Dude, even the elderly care about tomorrow.
I understand that. It sounds like a great rally, but we're not a political station, and you haven't really told us why people should do this. What is it about?
Look, do you want to help or not?
I don't know what I'm helping.
You're helping America. What kind of patriot are you? It's a rally.
You don't know what it's for, do you?
I started my exotic entertainment business with nothing but the sizable contents of my leather pants. A gang of no-goods has threatened to remove my starring member if I don't pay them a cut. Threaten the wrong man, amigo. They have a weakness for the ice cream. Pick up the bomb I've hidden in Hardwood, hijack the regular ice cream van on its rounds, and lure these fools to their doom with the jingly jingly. They hide in a warehouse on Atlantic Key.
Jam of non-stop rock from the station that can give you more because we pay our employees less.
Built from cheap labor from Zambia, El Salvador, and Paraguay.
mother's my sister.
There's no need to cool down.
Yep, I've been drinking again.
Some insolent triad stole my beautiful car last night, wrecked it, and left it burning. Some of my most precious donkey memorabilia was in the trunk. Real collectibles that are irreplaceable, my friend. I've hidden a throbbing weapon on the edge of Chinatown. Take it and teach these triad vandals to fear El Boros well in that wrath. Arriba!
Like, turn it on to 11 and burn those pounds away while you have a relaxing night's sleep. Now that I've lost 280 pounds, my husband's all mine again.
That's right, honey. No.
I'll get a few look at the Delta Quan being dropped in Portland area.
Remember, being fat can even ruin a romantic cruise. Call Dormitron now at 1-800-SLEEP-OFF-LARD or visit www.sleepofflard.com and sleep your way to a fitter, happier day.
In today's fast-paced world, a split second can be the difference between achieving your dreams.
Hey, I just won the Nobel Peace Prize!
And more Americans are realizing if you don't have the latest and greatest technological devices, you will fall behind.
I ended up Ray, my personal organizer, and 2 days later I was diagnosed with a terminal illness.
That's exactly why you should come visit the friendly people at House of Tomorrow, and they'll set you up with all your 21st century technology needs.
I only spent $20,000, and now I can get email in the shower or surf the internet while I'm driving. I'll just call it stupid if my daughter's beside me for my son's Little League games. Thanks to House of Tomorrow, I can play wireless head-to-head 3D virtual reality poker literally anywhere.
If it's a flash-in-the-pan technology of absolutely no use to anyone, you can find it at House of Tomorrow. Remember, only technology makes life worth living. House of Tomorrow. We'll upgrade your system, then you can upgrade your life.
A good shoe starts from the ground up. At Aeris, we make high-quality footwear. In fact, you can find Aeris running shoes in over 140 countries around the world. In the past, there's been some criticism about our workers. That's why I'm here at one of the Aeris factories so you can meet some of them. Excuse me, sir. Do you enjoy your job here?
It's fun. We get to play with knives.
I see. Is there a real sense of teamwork?
My friend Joey sewed his hands together.
Wow. You're learning some real skills. How about the salary and benefits? See, that's the kind of dedication we have to our employees and the quality of our shoes. Aeris running shoes. Always running from something.
The inspiration for this next record comes from Dante's Inferno, originally transcribed in Braille to a chaste Belgian monk after he lost his hearing. This powerful fugue can overpower the senses, much like a 12-year-old nephew who lets you bounce him on your knee one last time. Molto adagio.
In the suburbs and commutes to work on the highway. I live alone.
The name's Jocks, Marty Jocks. I run the bitch and dog food factory around the corner. I got money troubles, but hey, who doesn't, right? I'm meeting my bank manager later. He's a crooked bastard that keeps bumping up the loan repayment so he can cut a slice. Take my car, pick him up, and bring him back here. I got a little surprise for that blood-sucking leech.
your ass. Let's go and pay the fellow a visit.
Be bad for your karma. I studied the martial arts so I can stand up to bullies just like you, and I encourage everyone listening out there on Chatterbox to buy my book and learn how organic food and martial arts can help.
And I encourage anyone who needs a doorstop or booster seat to buy it as well. Let's see who's on the phones.
Is your final warning do not make me go into my dragon's dance.
Hello, caller. You are on the air.
Hello, Reed. I bought your book. It really saved my life.
Why, thank you.
I wanted to ask about chapter 29, yoga, not yogurt. I just can't give up cheese. So wonderful. I rejected chocolate milk and tapped butter out of my life. I've scooted around the house with my legs shaking behind my head for 2 days now. But my husband said I looked like a chicken exorcist. I even saw the dairy on the top shelf of the fridge and my legs shaking behind my head now. But I grew weak and start knocking things down with a broom. What can I do, Reed?
Do not threaten the child.
Keep searching.
Shut up, you carnivore. Why don't you go gnaw on a bone like a gorilla bad, though? Our ancestors didn't eat chicken wings. They lived their farms in the ecosystem, subsisting on a diet of nuts, berries, and leafy vegetables.
Yes, and they threw stones at their own shadow and died of old age and fear at 24.
Laszlo, the soul is eternal. But let me answer the question. When I'm in trouble or tempted by those all-you-can-eat breakfast buffets with huge pans of juicy bacon...
Can we get some bacon in here?
Laszlo, I go back to basics. I start the day with a fruity beverage, some...
Easy there, partner. Whoa! Put it down. Come on, put it down.
Drink two pints of canned breakfast.
And who wants a steak after that? Okay, next caller, you are on Chatterbox with Reed Tucker.
Yo, Reed, come to movies are dope. How can I learn to beat up 10 guys at once?
Okay, first things first, my man. You need to stop the negative thinking. And the best attack I've found is to just run away. That way you instill fear in me. You never know when you might descend from the rafters. Like a bat.
I don't want to hear about those old school running away. I want to learn about being a ninja.
Actually, I do cover this early on in the book in chapter 45. It's called Stir Fry Your Prejudice. You see, I once thought like you before my master took me under his wing and taught me the joys of soy and origami. Concentration begins in the mind and spreads to all the extremities of the body. You must use the language of the body, not the tongue. And the language of the body begins with raw, uncooked, organic vegetables. Just look at me. I could tear a phone book in half on my bare toes. In fact, Laszlo, I could easily chop this desk in two half desks.
This desk is made of 2-inch thick composite wood pulp, has a mahogany veneer finish, and has 3 drawers, and an annoying this station to cost $100. In his own words, Reed Tucker is about to smash it into 2 half desks. Take it away, Reed.
Ladies and gentlemen, I already visualized the desk in 2 half desks, and now I shall make it smaller. Into your hands. Hey-ya! Oh! Oh, Laszlo! Laszlo! I think I hurt my hand and my pinky's all bent the wrong way.
Listen, Karate Kid, the desk is still in one piece. Thanks for coming on the show.
Okay, Laszlo, mockery will get you nowhere. I think I'm gonna hit you now.
Oh, I breathe easily. Don't throw any tofu or bean curds at me.
Okay, very funny, Laszlo.
Thank you.
out my wife was seeing some guy I owe money to. He's got real angry, and he's looking for payback. I've agreed to see him. He thinks I'm gonna pay him off, but my guess is Liberty's dogs are gonna get yet another flavor this month.
My toolbox!
It's a rhythm.
Just step into my office. It's far too late for that, Marty. You had your chance, but now I'm taking over the business.
Asshole! Hooligan!
Wheels of Steel. I wonder if these CDs are steel. Today, it's all about the music. Next up, we got Boys to Girls, and this track's called Pray It Goes Okay.
6.
Get tired of boy bands. If you like checking out classic musicals, head down to Bedford Point where you can see Annie, Saturday Night Fever. I saw Saturday Night Fever. And did you know those little fellas? They never take a break. They just disco dance, jam bill. It's crazy.
This horrible music. This horrible. You're locked on Lips 107.
Going for a little ride into Epburn Heights. Kill me some filthy Diablo boo-boo spin batting up me Lady Queen Lizzie. You do the driving and the shooting and the dallying a boot. We'll make sure you don't get cold feet. Here, you'll need a piece.
Laughing vampires dance!
Let's drive.
Liberty City, arise! You're listening to Paris, the pacifist one, on Kinja!
You are a no good, you are a no good for the things that you do.
We accept that one again, because I liked it so much the first time. I just want more. Rewind!
Some filthy Diablos. Remember, you win this to the end, man. Hold your corner.
Knowledge is king! Knowledge is king, man! So we love the scientists here!
Now get us back to the yard. Go, 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 now!
We've got 5 seconds
to get back in the car, man.
You came the wrong way, Holmes! Better step aside, Holmes!
You got me right here on the site. You've got 5 seconds to get back in the car, man.
Take it away and bring it back again, Mr. Scientist. Yeah. Come on. Here we go now. Put away the weapons and turn up the bass. It's time to relax and cage up.
One over three.
I want you to steal me some gang car so we can do some naughty thing on our enemy turf. I want me a Mafia Sentinel, a Yakuza Stinger, and a Diablo Inferno so we can hit up any gang in Liberty. Drop them off at the garage in Newport and hear this. They're no use to me, all broke up now.
Just great. Next week, we've got our big bi-monthly phone-in when you get the chance to win a meal for two at a fast food outlet of your choice, as long as you choose one of our competition sponsors.
Finally, pop music's got a new voice.
Hello.
Welcome to Lips 106.
Hey, this is Andy on the Lips...
right now I see.
Come to daddy. Tick tock, what's on my clock?
Here you go, I got a present.
Come to daddy.
Come here.
Here you go, I got a present for you.
Come to daddy.
Come to daddy.
Come here.
Come to daddy.
I got your digits. You feel like chilling?
I left out my kids.
Niggas, you got them.
What am I, darling?
Feel like that, sir?
Oh, okay. Niggas, you got them.
Me.
You are listening to The Fat Lady Sings on Double Clef FM. I'm Morgan Merriweather. But please, call me the maestro.
then. Time for a commercial breakdown. You're listening to Flashback FM. I'm Tony, and I'll be right back where you left me.
Do you live in the boring suburbs but dream of living in a lonely castle on a windswept moor? Do you long to trade in your sweatsuit for a 100-pound suit of armor and swap your SUV for a noble stallion? Do you eat microwave dinners, all the while wishing you were roasting a suckling pig at a pagan banquet? Is your next ideal home improvement a moat? Well, get ready, Liberty City!
This weekend and every weekend at Liberty City Park, it's the medieval Millennium Fair. Our band of traveling minstrels, knights, and maidens oh so fair are ready to delight you with tales of the Black Death, witch burnings, and the joys of being a feudal serf. Forget about air conditioning and modern medicine. We've got all the leeches, spells, and potions you need at the medieval Millennium Fair. Learn the art of cooking with turnips. Yum, yum. Buy a genuine reproduction medieval artifacts, including maces, double-handed battle swords, and one-size-fits-all chainmail. And this weekend only, pick up an authentic mechanical Lady of the Lake in Excalibur. It's perfect for your garden pond or a swimming pool. And learn how to rid your condo of vermin using a penny whistle and a mysterious prancing German named Hans. The medieval Millennium Fair every weekend at Liberty City Park.
Flashback FM.
Flashback FM.
This is Flashback. Push it to the limit.
A Federal Reserve flight just smashed down at Francis International. There's platinum all over the strip. Get a car and snatch up as much as you can. You can drop the bling off at one of my garages. This platinum is mad heavy, and it'll slow your wheels down some. So make regular drop-offs at the garage.
Thank you.
You've called me Mike with another fat jam of non-stop rock from the station that can give you more because we pay our employees less.
Built from cheap labor from Zambia, El Salvador, and Paraguay. This is Head Radio.
I used to be concerned and nervous about poetry. Sometimes I'd get scared before an important event such as childbirth or a family funeral. Hey, sometimes you need a little help navigating life's trouble spots. That's when I discovered Equinox.
After the divorce and losing little Tommy, life was getting me down. I couldn't focus on anything at work. After trying Equinox, I've been employee of the month 3 times in a row. I used to fall unconscious for hours at a time. Now with Equinox, I never need to sleep. Equinox is new from Zaibatsu Pharmaceuticals. Ask your doctor about Equinox today.
Equinox may cause nausea, loss of sleep, blurred vision, leakage, kidney...
Oh!